So amazing how this world was made. I wonder if God is a woman.
Sometimes the king is a woman.
It's enough astounds me to this day. I give it up for the woman.
If you think it's not valid, then you owe it to yourself to learn carefully from this unusual woman who made it her responsibility to distinctively address various psychosocial factors that have adversely affected the well-being and general development of the boy child.
That's a woman. She'll put a smile upon her face and take you to the higher place. So don't you underestimate the strength of a woman.
For over a year now, RoseMary Mutoni Kinuthia is single-handedly running the initiative of over 150 men of all ages, molding future fathers by promoting the rights of the boy child, mobilizing, highlighting, enlightening, and addressing the plight of the boy child, spearheading sustainable overhaul transformation of the boy child for better communities.
She can nag and be a constant pain. Oh, that woman. But those hips, she's got to be whipped. And it's just too hard.
Nasikia kila kitu. Nasikia kuna initiative za girl child. Lakini sijawahi sikia pali boy child anahusishwa.
Watoto vijana, countrywide, wamekuwa wakibaguliwa sana. Na wamekuwa wakidiscriminatiwa sana.
Men's Castle, an organization that promotes the forgotten rights of the boy child and campaigns for the well-being of the male figure, is a welcome relief for men.
Today, and you've heard, girls are being empowered. They're actually becoming the boys. Because when you wake up in the morning, it is about the girl. You eat lunch, it's about the girl. In the evening, it's about the girl. The present stands, it's about the girl. The NGOs, we have so many NGOs about the girl. What are you saying? What are you saying? Does it mean that all men are wealthy enough that they no longer need to be supported? Are you saying that? Are you saying that the boy, even at birth, is empowered enough that he doesn't need support?
Persistent campaigns to address the plight of the girl child have caused a negative bearing on the affairs of the boy child.
When you go to a school, it's a mixed school, and someone stands in front of a class and says something like, what a woman can do, what a man can do, or man can do. What are you telling the boys? I feel that if you have, as a parent, you have two kids, and one is doing really well at school, another is not. As a parent, you're supposed to make sure that you is doing very well at school. What you're doing in this country is that you're actually lifting the one that's not doing well in school and deliberately bringing down the one that does well in school.
Over the years, the society has continually neglected the boy child, causing a fallout that is reflected by the high numbers of males dropping out of school, abusing drugs, engaging in criminal activities, and lately being radicalized into extremist organizations.
I feel we need to change how we approach this. We need to assure our boys, we need to assure our men, it's not war against them. We are not replacing them. But what we want is equality, and that equality needs to be achieved in a fair manner.
The initiative promotes the physical, social, emotional, and psychological health and facilitates training programs for men and the youth to prepare them for the adult role of fatherhood.
We have funds for women. Remember, today in this country, if you're a man above 36 years, you don't actually qualify, there's no fund made for you. Are you saying men above 36 years don't have businesses? Are you saying men above 36 years don't have families? Are you seeing men above 36 years, they've grown that they don't need to grow again? These are fathers of young children. What are you telling them? And my big question is, a man of 36 years and above, they're still paying tax. Why would you use their tax to empower a different gender and deny them opportunity?
Conditions such as poverty and unemployment have further worsened the conditions for the boy child.
We have a lot of frustrated young men. It does not matter how much you've empowered your girl. It does not matter. That girl will become a teenager. She'll have a boyfriend. She'll come across a very frustrated boy. You know what's going to happen? He will kill her. That daughter of yours that you've empowered so well will get married. He'll find an irresponsible and frustrated husband. So what you're doing, you're actually going around the cycles. And it can only get worse if we don't do something.
The youth and particularly students are especially vulnerable to the vice owing to peer pressure, poor guidance and role modeling. The problem has taken root in learning institutions leading to high numbers of school dropouts and idleness.
We need to give somebody an opportunity. We need to give them something to do. There's no way you can save a young man from drugs. There's no way you can save a young man from radicalization. There's no way you can save a young man from alcoholism if he has nothing to do.
A father figure is considered vital in the upbringing of a boy child. Single motherhood is one of the key factors that have enhanced the challenge to bring up a boy child in the right approach. A range of factors including peer pressure and the struggle to cope with modernization are blamed for the trend in which 3 in 10 Kenyan girls become pregnant at the age of 18.
And the other thing is that we have a lot of single mothers in this country. And it's important that we realize that single mothers cannot make boys men. So there's a need that the single mothers should be able to expose their sons to men around them. It could be their fathers, it could be their brothers, because this world is mature men. And there's no way we'll get to that level where we've left our boys to just wait around.
As we await the forthcoming elections in 2017, Rosemary feels of the significance to engage the young idle men with productive activities to deter them from being used by politicians to incite violence.
Chances this coming election might just go through. We might not have a lot of heads hitting each other. But come 2022, I believe it will be a new kind of election. If we do not take care of idle young men around, if we do not do something, we'll have a bunch of so many young men just waiting for an election. And one thing is that when you're lying somewhere doing nothing, you can anybody coming to offer you anything, you will take.